Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Drew, aka the Redrew89, and you are looking at, well, a female dark elf. So this is, of course, Skyrim, the Elder Scrolls V Skyrim, and I figured it was about time that I started to go ahead and do a little bit of a let's play through this game. Played this game actually, well, I've played through most of the content once, and then I've had a couple of other attempts at going through again. Ended up having to abort them halfway through due to various reasons like save file corruption or having to reformat my PC or something like that. Hopefully this time I can avoid those issues and we can actually get a decent playthrough. So, what am I doing? What is my character's story here? Well, this is going to be sort of a roleplay-inspired type of let's play. I'm also going to try to avoid as much metagaming as possible to a certain extent. I mean, there's going to be a certain strategy that I'm going to employ throughout this game, but and you'll notice that I'm also starting a little ways in. I've completed, you know, the initial introduction sequence, I guess, the whole tutorial quest that they start you with, and then I also went and took care of the Golden Claw real quick, and now I'm about to go to Whiterun to basically skip straight into the main quest, which, yeah, so let me just do something here real quick. So yeah, the whole the build that I'm going with, and this is a modded playthrough that you might be able to tell from this thing over here. I got a lot of mods, including Midas, a couple other mods as well that I won't get into. Just random stuff, lots of random stuff. I'll mention here and there things that I've got. Like for instance, you'll notice that I've got this knapsack, which is just the carry weight fortify thing, yeah, this thing. Carrying capacity increased by 35 points. Yeah, I like it. It works. So yeah, I've got wet and cold, cloaks of Skyrim. Winter is coming. That's the one I've got. And then other random stuff everywhere. And I'll mention stuff as it comes up, but
you're not from around.
But yeah, there's a lot of stuff that we can do in this playthrough, so. Also got all the DLC content, so expect to see me fighting vampires and going to Solstheim here and there along the way. So, to those of you who are not familiar with the Elder Scrolls or Skyrim, well, where the hell have you been, for one thing? For another thing, it's basically just a fantasy role-playing game, and my character, as you might have already noticed, is a dark elf. One of the several races of, we'll say, humanoids within the Elder Scrolls universe, dark elf, and the character's name is, and this actually is one that I'm actually having trouble with. It's Ilori, Lyedrai, something like that. Lyedrai. I don't know how you would want to pronounce that. It doesn't matter. It was just a random name generator that I rolled a couple of times, and that's what I came up with that I thought sounded decent. Basic build idea, we're going to go with full mage. Now, this is kind of a departure from what I normally do. I normally go more toward the route of, like, spell sword, where my primary, I'm using a melee weapon one-handed, and then in my offhand, I'm doing, like, restoration or destruction. I'm going to go with a more magic-oriented build this time around, and I think that'll make things a little more interesting. Let me go ahead and equip, because I'm gonna go ahead and make my way to Whiterun, but, so yeah, there's the whole loadout right there, and of course I've also got the cloak for, I don't know, for role-playing purposes when I'm in cold weather. So let's go ahead and just start making our way out to Whiterun, so that we can go ahead and get started with the next part of the main quest. So I've already returned the Golden Claw, and I'm pretty much prepared at this point to go start doing some stuff. So yeah. Just make our way along through here. Oh, that's right. Also have realistic lighting overhaul as well as the illuminated spells add-on for it, which I think gives it a decent effect, because you'll notice that surrounding my character's feet, there's a cool little glow pattern from the equipped spells. It's kind of nice. I don't know. It's one of those little immersion things that's kind of nice to have. Going along here. There's Whiterun. Off in the distance. To those of you, again, who are relatively new to the whole... Who's this guy?
Greetings, sister. You look weird.
Oh.
I have something to
you're,
help you. Relax, if you're
You're a skooma dealer. Really?
The finest skooma. The sweetest moon sugar. At a fair price, of course.
Do I want to? I kinda do.
A snitch, eh? Can't have you
okay,
running
so you're
to
try
guards now.
What are you gonna do? What are you gonna do? Oh.
Come
on. Hold up. Do not deal well with flames, do you? Or rather, you don't really care. Gosh. I didn't want to do that. There. Drop.
Trade a Stendar while you
drop,
can.
Damn you. What the hell? What the hell? What? I'm calling shenanigans on that. You were supposed to drop. Alright. Time to go melee on you.
You puny weak.
Drop. There. Gimme yo stuff. Take it. Yeah. Never gets old, really. Let's go ahead and go back to the front. To the flames. The flames. I don't know why, I always liked fire magic. So that was entertaining. That was actually kind of unexpected. I mean, I've had that random world encounter before, where you run into the random orc that's carrying a bunch of moon sugar and skooma and stuff. But generally I don't encounter them this early in the game. That's actually kind of a stroke of luck, because in particular the sleeping tree sap is rather useful.
Got hit by a dragon. One of those horrors comes here. We'll be there.
So it's good to have. Oh, hey look, there's a giant. Let's go. Even though we're probably not going to get there in time.
I'm going to crush you like a bug.
Are you prepared to die?
Aw, what? Easy. No! Oh. Damn it. Well, let's try this again, I guess. a bunch of Imperial soldiers. Boring. I am kind of PO'd now because that sleeping tree sap would have come in real handy. But, oh well. So this time we're just going to ignore the giant, because to be honest, I don't really have much of an interest in joining the companions right now, and there's no point anyway. I mean, the giant doesn't drop anything, I don't even have a soul trap, so, and I don't even have a soul gem, so, no point. We'll let them handle it, they're the professionals.
City's closed with the dragons about. Official business only. Fine. But we'll be keeping an eye on you.
Easy speech increase. I'll take it.
Must have more swords for the Imperial soldiers.
I just can't fill an order that size on my own. Why don't you swallow that stubborn pride of yours and ask Yorland Greyman for help?
For a bull banger?
I'd sooner bend my knee to Ulfric's Stormcloak. Besides, Greyman would never make steel for the Legion.
Have it your way. I'll take the job, but don't expect the miracle.
Oh, shoot. I forgot to turn off notifications. Oh, well.
Got some good pieces out here if you're looking to buy. More inside.
Well, let's go ahead. One thing I did do is I stopped. I went through Ember Shard Mine on my way back from Bleak Falls Barrow. Went through and cleared that out real quick. Got all kinds of irons. So I'm going to go ahead and... I don't know if I'm really going to have much use for smithing, but I may think about investing in it. I don't know. I think I'm actually just going to stick with, and it's not something I'm going to be used to, but I think I'm just going to go ahead and stick with,
Take a look.
The whole conjuration thing. And just go unarmored. Because it's actually significantly overpowered at higher levels. I mean, you get the high level alteration skills, and the mage armor perk. You can actually get pretty darn powerful. So I'm not worried about it right now. It's already got decent enough gear. I'm just gonna go ahead and. ahead and scurry on.
I can handle but this talk of dragons.
Don't ask me why, but one of the role playing things I like to do is I like to remove the headgear when in the presence of a Jarl. Just, you know, one of those little quirks. Not only that, but works from a role-playing standpoint.
What's the meaning of this interruption?
Don't worry, Aeroleth. Don't worry.
Who's this then? Well, that explains why the guards let you in. Come on, then. The Jarl will want to speak to you personally.
You saw this dragon with your own eyes? Really? You're certainly forthright about your criminal past. But it's none of my concern who the Imperials want to execute, especially now. What I want to know is, what exactly happened at Helgen? Ireleth was right. What do you say now, Proventus? Shall we continue to trust in the strength of our walls against the dragon?
My lord, we should send troops to Riverwood at once. It's in the most immediate danger. If that dragon is lurking in the mountains...
That is a provocation. He'll assume we're preparing to join Ulfric's side and attack him.
I also have player head tracking installed, which is kind of subtle, but once you notice it, it's actually kind of a nice touch.
Send a detachment to Riverwood at once.
Basically what that does is it allows, when you're in third-person mode, it basically, when dialogue is occurring between two or more NPCs, the player will look between whichever NPC is speaking. That's kind of neat.
I won't forget it. Here, take this as a small token of my esteem.
I don't need armor, though. Why are you giving me armor?
Another thing you could do for me. Suitable for someone of your particular talents, perhaps. Come, let's go find Faringar, my court wizard. He's been
looking into a matter related to this dragon. I think I've got something he wants anyway.
Rumors of dragons.
I didn't say that. After you.
Faringar, I think I've found someone who can help you with your dragon project. Go ahead and fill her in with all the details.
So the Jarl thinks you can be of use to me. Oh yes, he must be referring to my research into the dragon. Yes, I could use someone to fetch something for me. Well, when I say fetch, I really mean delve into a dangerous ruin in search of an ancient stone tablet that may or may not actually be there. You are eager to begin your adventure. Excellent. I, learned of a certain stone tablet said to be housed in Bleakfall's Barrow. A dragon stone, said to contain a map of dragon burial sites.
go to Bleak Falls Barrow, find this tablet, no doubt interred in the main chamber, and bring it to me. Simplicity itself.
Oh, do you mean this?
The Dragon Stone of Bleak Falls Barrow. You already found it. You are cut from a different cloth than the usual boots the Jarl foists on me. That is where your job ends and mine begins. The work of the mind, sadly undervalued in Skyrim.
Varengar. Varengar, you need to come at once. A dragon's been sighted nearby. You should come too.
A dragon? How exciting. Where was it seen? What was it doing?
I'd take this a bit more.
So the downside to this is that I miss a little bit of foreshadowing that you normally get if you were to go talk to Varengar before getting the Dragonstone. And to those of you that are already familiar with Skyrim, it's no surprise what that is, but there's a character that appears if you do it in the order that the game expects. Well, it's not necessarily expected, but the way a lot of people do it is to go to Whiterun first and then go back and get it. But,
what did it do? All this standing around is rubbish. We should be taking the fight to the Stormcloaks.
Circling overhead when I left. I never ran so fast in my life. I thought we'd have come off
for
sure.
I'm not a man. I'm a weapon in human form.
We'll
just unsheathe
it
and point
head
me at
down
the
to the barracks for some food and rest. You've earned it. Irulet. Better gather
my
some
brother takes counsel from
there.
Proventus Avenici.
I've already
laugh,
ordered my
he takes counsel from his daughter.
I wish everyone would stop talking at the same time.
Don't fail me. There's no time to stand on ceremony, my friend. I need your help again. I want you to go with Irileth and help her fight this dragon. You survived Helgen, so you have more experience with dragons than anyone else here. But I haven't forgotten the service you did for me in retrieving the Dragonstone for Varengar. As a token of my esteem, I have instructed Avenici that you are now permitted to purchase property in the city. And please, accept this gift from my personal armory.
I should come along. I would very much like to.
Okay, I'll take those boots. I like those boots. We'll go ahead and put the.
No.
Yeah.
Can't
let's
afford
go.
To risk hope. I need you here working on ways to defend the city against.
Actually, before I go kill a dragon, let's go. Let's do this real quick. Give me that. And then. I don't want to do that yet. There's nothing here I can enchant because I don't have a filled soul gem right now. So, alright, I think it's time we moseyed on out of here.
I've seen you helping the Yard. If only all visitors to Whiterun were as noble.
Gods and Dragonreach say you've aided the Yard.
No signs of any dragon right now. But it sure looks like he's been. I know it looks bad, but we've got to figure out what happened. And if that dragon is still skulking around somewhere. Spread out and look for survivors. We need to know what we're seeing.
It's still here somewhere. Brocky and Tor just got grabbed when they tried to make a run for it.
Godman, what happened here? Where's this dragon? Quickly now!
I don't know. Kinneret, save us. Here he comes again.
Here he comes. Find cover.
Is this guy a frost dragon or a regular dragon? Fire dragon? Nobody. Let's go ahead and give our restoration a boost.
tales. Back from when there were still dragons in Skyrim. The Dragonborn would slay dragons and steal their power. That's what you did, isn't it? Absorb the dragon's power. Well, you can shout now. You couldn't before, right? That can only mean one thing. You must be Dragonborn.
Really? Well, that's kind of ironic.
There weren't any dragons then. They're just coming back now for the first time in forever.
Well, I guess we make our way back to Whiterun. Do 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 do.
Someone in Whiterun. You will pay good money for information. A woman, a foreigner in these lands. She's likely not using her true name. We will pay for any information regarding her location. We are not welcome here in Whiterun, so we will be in Rorikstead if you learn anything. We're looking for a fugitive who comes from Hammerfell. A Redguard woman. She may be somewhere in the city.
Oh, hey.
Will be your destiny.
He's did it.
Christmas.
Who killed the dragon?
Ooh, maybe preparing.
There's been talk amongst the gods that you are dragonborn. But such a thing, surely that's not possible. What do you need?
I spend a lot of time at the market stall so I can learn the merchant's trade. I need more experience if I'm going to run an inn someday.
Gotta keep my eyes open. Damn dragons could swoop down at any time.
What is it, Emmy?
Thank you.
Stahl's been waiting for you.
You heard the summons. What else could it mean?
The Greybeards.
We were just talking about you. My brother needs a word with you.
So what happened at the watchtower? Was the dragon there? I knew I could count on Irileth. But there must be more to it than that. Dragonborn. What do you know about the Dragonborn? So it's true. Greybeards really were summoning you. Masters of the Way of the Voice. They live in seclusion, high on the slopes of the throat of the world. The Dragonborn is said to be uniquely gifted in the voice. The ability to focus your vital essence into a doom or shout. If you really are Dragonborn, they can teach you how to use your gift.
Didn't you hear the thundering sound as you returned to Whiterun? That was the voice of the Greybeards, summoning you to High Hrothgar. This hasn't happened in centuries, at least. Not since Tiber Septim himself was summoned when he was still Talos of Atmora.
Rangar, calm yourself. What does any of this Nord nonsense have to do with our friend here? Capable as she may be, I don't see any signs of her being this, what, Dragonborn.
Nord nonsense? Why, you puffed up ignorant. These are our sacred traditions that go back to the founding of the First Empire.
Rangar, don't be so hard on Avanich.
I meant no disrespect, of course. It's just that, what do these Greybeards want with her?
That's the Greybeards' business, not ours. Whatever happened when you killed that dragon, it revealed something in you, and the Greybeards heard it. If they think you're Dragonborn, who are we to argue? We'd better get up to High Hrothgar immediately. There is no refusing the summons of the Greybeards. It's a tremendous honor. I envy you, you know, to climb the 7,000 steps again. I made the pilgrimage once. Did you know that? High Hrothgar is a very peaceful place. Very disconnected from the troubles of this world. I wonder that the Greybeards even notice what's going on down here. They haven't seemed to care before. No matter. Go to High Hrothgar. Learn what the Greybeards can teach you.
You've done a great service for me and my city, Dragonborn. By my right as Jarl, I name you Thane of Whiterun. It's the greatest honor that's within my power to grant. I assign you Lydia as a personal housecarl, and this weapon from my armory to serve as your badge of office. I'll also notify my guards of your new title. Wouldn't want them to think you're part of the common rabble, now would we? We are honored to have you as Thane of our city, Dragonborn.
Okay.
We still have a city to defend.
Yes, my lord.
Well, alright. What did they give me? Axe of Whiterun. Yeah, that's getting disenchanted. Let's go do that now.
Come to Dragon's Reach to discuss the ongoing hostilities, like the rest of the great warriors?
It seems this damnable conflict has claimed everyone's passions of late. Me, I prefer my books and my spells.
A prospective student, are you? Well, I'm afraid I'm not much good at teaching. You should try your luck at the College of Winterhold.
craft. Take an enchanted weapon or piece of armor, then use... Once you know an enchantment, you'll need a filled soul gem and something to enchant. Of course, I have everything you need for sale if you have the coin. Spells and incantations for those...
Let's see what you got for spells first. You got bound stuff. Conjuration's always kind of cool. Candlelight is also kind of useful. Fast healing. Yeah. Fireball. Oh. Yeah. Do I want the apprentice destruction spells now? I don't think I have enough money. Don't leave as to cash. I could sell you that. Keeping that. Damn it. Let's grab Firebolt. And Ice Spike. Lightning Bolt. Have Oak Flesh, Soul Trap. Oh, I don't have... Oh. Stone Flesh? Damn it.
You know, if... Got...
But I just boosted myself here. Let's just go ahead and do that. I also grabbed another alteration, didn't I? Oh, yeah, candlelight. Okay.
The Jarl has appointed me to be your house, Carl. It's an honor to serve you.
Okay.
Honor to you, my friend.
Okay.
Settlements in the hold. Unwalled, lightly manned. Five targets from the staff side.
All right. At this point, I think there's one last thing I'm going to do at this point. I'm going to go ahead and progress a little bit further with the whole, with that one. This right here, I'm going to go ahead and get the next step in, which, because it's easy, and I'm right here. So, let's just go ahead and...
Sadia, wake up, dear.
Yes, Mom.
Want to hear a little Nord wisdom? You don't really know a woman until you have a strong drink and a fist fight with her.
You want a drink? Are you sure? Oh no. They found me? I need your help. Please, come with me. I need to speak to you privately. Quickly, come with me.
I ain't done nothing.
That better be important.
Oh, there once was a hero named Ragnar the Red.
saddles in gold he had made.
So, are you working with them? You think you can need something? So the Alakir know where I am? What do they offer you? Gold? How many more of them are coming? Tell me. Then I need your help, and there isn't anyone else I can trust here in this. I am not the person that the people of Whiterun think I am. My real name is Eamon. I am a noble of House Suda in Hammerfell. The men who are looking for me, the Alakir, they are assassins in the employ of the Almari Dominion. They wish to exchange my blood for gold. I need you to root them out and drive them away before they find me and drag me back to Hammerfell for an execution. They're mercenaries, only in it for the money. They're led by a man named Kamatu. Get rid of him, and the rest will scatter. I don't dare show my face, lest they recognize me, so you'll have to find out where they are. I heard one of them was just arrested trying to sneak into the city. If you... Please, I know I'm asking you to do something difficult, maybe even dangerous. I just don't know who else... You think I'd be in hiding if this was... These men are ruthless, cunning, deceitful. They'll pay off whoever they can. Guards and Jarls can be bought. And the Alakir are close. I'm running out of time, so I'm choosing to trust you. I mean it. I'll cut you in half.
Well, shit, girl. Easy. Easy. Okay. So at this point, yeah, it's like in-game, it is late. Go ahead and
I enjoy the
rent a room.
Sure, sure thing. It's yours for a day.
I ain't right done this nothing.
Way. Need anything else? Just let me know.
So I think this is where I'm going to go ahead and wrap things up for now, guys. Take a quick break. Maybe do some other random side questing for a little bit. Need to make more gold. Eventually, my next goal... I think before I go visit the Greybeards, I am going to go to Winterhold, so I can get started with that, because obviously, if this is going to be a mage-type character, I'm going to
need
to put a lot of effort into getting that leveled up, so, and also getting access to the spells and gear and stuff, be very handy, so. Until next time, this has been Drew, aka Redrew89, in the wonderful world of Skyrim. Take care.